Hey, what's up everyone? In this video, we're going to be installing and trying out Windows 11 on Parallels running on a Mac with an M1 Max chip in it. So, of course, with running Windows on a Mac with Apple Silicon, there's a lot of, you know, quirks to it that you need to keep in mind. You can't just download the regular Windows 10 or Windows 11 ISO and then expect it to work flawlessly, because the Macs with Apple's chips are ARM-based chips, so they can't run x86 architecture. They need to have an actual ARM format to them. So we're going to be using Parallels Desktop 17, which is Parallels' latest version of their very popular software. It's supported on Intel and Apple M1 Max, so shouldn't have any compatibility issues there. Now, installing Windows, it's going to be a little bit tricky. Again, you know, you can't just download the regular ISO file. And in this case, we can't even download Windows 10. Windows 11, though, does have an option for an ARM version. Essentially, we're going to be running like a beta version of Windows 11 through Microsoft's Windows Insider Preview. As of right now, mid to late November, this is the only way to, you know, be able to run this by joining the Insider Preview. So I did that, and I'm currently downloading the file right now, so that should be done pretty soon. Okay, so now that the Windows 11 Insider Preview is done downloading, let's go ahead and we opened up Parallels, ready to install Windows using an image file. We'll continue on. We'll select the file. Okay, we will continue. We'll use this, or we'll just say productivity. Windows 11. Okay, so we have the Windows 11 configuration. Let's see, total size 10 gigabytes. That doesn't seem like a lot, but we'll see. Just curious to see what kind of like default settings we get here. All right, we'll leave it at that. Okay, so disk space 256, memory 8 gigabytes. We can give it a little bit more RAM. We'll do 12 gigabytes, that should be plenty. All right, continue. And now it's gonna start it up. Okay, so the installation is complete. We can click to continue and we'll go into full screen mode. And let's just see how it is. So seems to be pretty smooth. It's installing some updates. And now one of the kind of major things with the Insider Preview of Windows 11 is that it has an x64 emulator built into it. So it, even though it's technically like an ARM version, it has the ability to run native, you know, regular apps. So let's test that out. We'll wait until it's done installing these updates, and then we're going to try to install some files on here and see, you know, how far we can get with this ARM version. Okay, so I went ahead and downloaded Steam and I installed CSGO because why not? This game is mainly CPU intensive, so this is really just a test of the CPU performance within Parallels, within an Insider Preview of Windows 11, within an emulator essentially. So a lot of emulation going on. It's like one of those Russian dolls where it's just, you open it up and there's another doll inside. Basically this Mac OS running Parallels, running Windows, a special version of Windows, which is running an emulator within that in order to run these programs. So, you know, my expectations are pretty low, but we'll see what happens. So again, the settings for with it for Parallels running Windows 11 is that it's using four cores, I believe. I don't remember how it has those cores broken up, of how many efficiency and how many high performance cores, but either way, we'll open up Task Manager just to see. So here's our four cores, 3.2 gigahertz, and hopefully CSGO pops up soon. All right, so we have CSGO running. Let's see if we can get an FPS counter. I'm not sure if CSGO has one built in. Okay, we're just gonna use Steam's then. Let's see here. All right, so we have the FPS counter in the top left corner. That is the Steam's FPS counter. Let's see if, I'm not sure if we'll even need like VSync or anything to keep it at 120, but let's just jump into a game and see what happens. I don't even have a mouse connected to this MacBook Pro, so I'm just gonna use the trackpad and keyboard. Probably won't be too fun, but we'll see what happens. All right, and it looks like we got an error, so that's not good. We'll try this one more time. Alright, and it looks like it just quit again. It's not really wanting to load up CSGO, or at least not joining a game. So yeah, I mean, Windows 11, the ARM Insider Preview works. It's definitely able to emulate programs. It's emulating Steam right now, so Steam's running perfectly fine. And I expect it to run any other, you know, normal x86 architecture program just fine as well. However, when it comes to gaming, I would probably just stick with a, you know, dedicated Windows computer, because, you know, it's just not the best experience when it comes to this. You know, I'm sure there's other games that would work just fine. However, you know, a program like CSGO should run on anything that has a pretty decent CPU. But you know, it's just a little too buggy. Insider Preview, not really what it's meant to be for or used for. So that's it for this video. If you guys want me to test out anything else using Parallels and Windows 11 on the MacBook Pro with the M1 Max processor, let me know in the comments down below. Otherwise, thanks for watching this very interesting video, and I'll see you in the next one.